guys, welcome back. Jeez, it's been an awfully long time since I've recorded for Skyrim. And oh yes, corpses. Corpses everywhere. Oopsie. I stopped recording a little while after being extremely ill, which you would have heard in the last Skyrim episode that I posted, which was going back nearly a month now. Jeez, that's bad. Anyway, as I recall, supposed to be kicking Aringoth's ass. Well, actually, no, not specifically harming Aringoth. That's bad. Both for me and the guild. Cicero, you be super duper quiet, please. Also, I've got nothing but my character's butt in my face. There we go. Ooh, what's in the strong box? Probably something absolutely useless. Corundum ingots, pretty important actually. Well, it was mainly important as of Hearthfire. Then again, if you needed specific armors like, I think it was, no, do you want the broom? You can have the broom back. Banded iron armor, banded iron shield. Is there something in the void? What else? Pretty sure there's an elven armor that requires corundum. Somebody would have that in their freaking house, but hey ho. Mission always has me so freaking paranoid. That's where we came from. Ooh, easy. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Talking of which, there's banded iron armor. Jeez. What's in this chest? Also, I love being this higher level because seriously, you're just gonna whistle, Cicero? Thanks, just get me shot. There's one dude. Do I? Come on then. Also, say, you delightful bugger. I think I put all my Dark Brotherhood stuff away, didn't I? Yeah, I did. Oops. Seriously? Douche. Now I forgot I have this on a slightly higher difficulty.
Cannot mess.
Thank you. stupid mustache. Sister, what are you doing? Seriously, buddy? Okay, you're just gonna...
There's no escape!
Just... enough! Just stand there, that's fine, dude. Cicero, where have you gone? Honestly, dude. Please tell. Don't tell me you've run upstairs and killed Aringoth. I would not be impressed. Though, no, it's a loading door, isn't it? Cicero! Dude! Where the hell are you? Are you just still fighting someone? Cicero?
Pretty, pretty flower.
I can hear you talking about mother, but... don't tell me you've got stuck somewhere. Dude. Behind the doors. Cicero, you have me worried. Are you trapped in a wall?
Break that loot across.
Cicero. Oh no. I'm sure one of these guys has got the key anyway. Cicero. I hear you, but I do not see you.
Madness.
Sister, you, oh. What the hell? What the hell are you doing in here? You're just stashing a corpse or something. Dude. You had me worried. I thought you stuck somewhere. Jeez.
What?
Oh, I'm going around in circles. Thanks, Cicero. Jeez. Crazy fool.
No. Just my head playing tricks. Cicero.
That was it. Yes, this way. Right, what's behind the locked door? More goodies? Give me the goodies. 12 gold. 12 freaking gold. Can you believe that, Cicero? We're gonna go upstairs, aren't
we? Need a sweet roll. Or a carrot.
Dude, you're bizarre. Gold. Gimme, 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 even though I don't really need it. I don't care. That's the one I wanted. Seriously? Did I just... Oh. Cicero, come on.
you go?
I don't know. I didn't see. Oh, you're still in the next room, aren't you? I'll have those. Thank you. Okay.
Oh well. Must have run off.
Those subtitles were on there for an awfully long time. Right. Oh, is he going back for sleepy bays? Are you going for sleepy bays? Give to Alwyn, thank you. Come on, no. Thank you. What have we got? Gold. Leather helm. Gold 64. Not bad. Good console. You know. 64 stacks of items in Minecraft. Good number. Dwarven dagger. Thank you. Scissor out, come on, dude, seriously. Can't hurt to have a good bit of garlic either. Right. Oh, he's dead. Scissor out, you did nothing. So. Intentionally not to kill Aringoth, unless of course I absolutely have to. Yoink. Let's talk to the little cretin. I don't know if you can see him that well. Where's my torch? There we go.
I didn't think Maven or Mercer would allow me to get away with this, but I had little choice.
Oh,
I didn't
really
think Maven or Mercer would allow me to get away with this, but I had little choice.
Don't go revealing yourself, dude. You're crazy.
I can't. If I do, I may as well cut my own throat.
Well, dude, seriously, you've got two choices. Either you give me the key, or I kill you. There you go.
Fine. Take it. Once the new owner finds out I gave in, I'm as good as dead anyway.
I don't think so. I'm pretty sure my foresight will allow me to know who the new owner is, and therefore you, my dear boy, will not die. But I'll oblige. Let's have a little word.
I've already said too much. I gave you what you came in here for. Now go. Leave me in peace.
I think I will, Aringoth. Also, you're rocking an awesome beard, especially for an old man. Oh, it's the bee in the jar. Bloody big bee. Thank you. Now, wasn't there? Yes. Queen Bee statue. In each of the Thieves Guild main quests, there are rather nice trinkets you can find, and it's quite easy to miss them as well. But yeah. Ooh, golden blood. You can actually take these items to Delvin and he'll buy them off you and put them in a rather nice display case behind Mercer's desk. However, they're not locked to it, so you can just help yourself to them afterwards. So you can get paid for them and still get the trinkets, which is just freaking awesome. Also, I'm now getting caught up in tiny rooms and stuff, and get confused. I don't like. So now we can go downstairs and clear out the safe. Nobody else has to die. Oh, except the mercenaries. It's over. Infidel. Pardon? Who are you talking to? Where the hell are you hiding? Seriously, I'm in superior armor. You walking around in leather. Oops, I missed that one. And I'm walking around in glass, so I think you died first. Thank you. Ooh. Anything of worth? Oh, I can't set fire to that stuff. Right. There's some mercenaries. See if I can kill your buddy with a headshot. Hit me like a... No, isn't it your best shot? I don't know. I can't remember the song. Dude!
I knew I heard
something. Cicero! I'm dying!
It's nothing.
Cicero dead in the back with an arrow. I'm sorry. My buddy.
That's it. That's all you've got. You've already lost.
No. Boys, seriously? Dudes, back off. Jeez. Cicero, I'm so sorry for the arrow. I wonder if he's in his inventory. That would be hilarious. Take all that. Sell a key, thank you.
Cicero is at your service, oh great and powerful listener.
Oh, I love you, Cicero.
Listener? Oh, that tickles.
Oh, excuse me.
Humble Cicero lives to serve.
Oh, you're brilliant. Oh, and you've got the cellar key as well. Well then. Yes, and I'm missing barrels and whatnot, but I don't need to. Oh, so there's some furs in here. Hungry. Yeah, pretty furs. Do-do-do-do-do. Gimme. Slaughtered flesh. Yeah, flesh? What's it flesh? Slaughter fish, taxidermied, and on a wonderful little plaque board plaque thing. Shh. English, not good. It's too hot.
You're as good as dead.
Cicero.
Damn you!
You must think you could set fire to that, but no. No, nobody else. Ta-da! Right, more gold, 78. Cicero, you twisted maniac. Bill of sale. Gold. Should I read it or not? Doesn't say who. Ooh. And away we go. This is another access way, and then straight out. There we go. Hello, Mr. Wolfie, with your weird anti-belly buttons? Or is that a brand, or are they nipples because you're a dog? I can't quite tell. Because you've only got the two. Anyway, we're out now, so once again, loading screens. Let's go see good old Aringoth. If you adopt, yay, go speak to Constance. No, because they're fine. They're with Constance now. She can look after them. There are other children starving out in the streets who need a home, of which I have none. Well, no, I have a home, but not fit for children. Thank you. Excuse me. Also, I want a wife. So, that'll be good. Yay! And sorry, I think that's a vacuum cleaner from next door. If it's picking up on the capture. Aringoth! Let's not suffer. You offered to talk to me.
Look, if I was a little harsh before, I just want you to know it's because you were new. Know what I mean?
So what's your name, Sapphire?
Look, I don't really know you. I don't even really know anyone here. Why do you care anyway? It's not like we're family. This is a business.
I'll leave it to you. I'll have some information later. Anyway, Aringoth, my dear boy. Let me just try that again and be more professional. Aringoth.
Word on the street is Golden Glow's been hit. Good job, lass.
Yep, and here's all the stuff that was in the safe.
Let me take a look at what you found. Aringoth sold Golden Glow? What's that idiot thinking? He has no idea the extent of Maven's fury when she's been cut out of a deal. But I'm certain he'll find out.
Well,
if only the parchment had the buyer's name instead of this odd symbol. Any idea what that might be?
I haven't got a clue.
Blast. Well, I'll check my sources and speak to Mercer. But for now, you're off to speak to Maven Blackbriar. She asked for you by name.
Oh.
No, nothing like that. You're calling on her for business.
And, what does Maven want?
That's between you and Maven, and I prefer to keep it that way. Don't worry about it. Maven's business dealings usually involve quite a bit of gold for her people.
Ooh, well, yes, speaking of gold, my dear boy.
Of course, your pay. You're smart as a whip, lass. Keep doing right by us, and there's plenty more where that came from.
Hey, 100 for that job. I suppose for the work we're in, it's acceptable. Also, this is where all of our trinkets will end up, including the crown of Baron Zaya, if I ever bother to complete it. which I guess. Some fun. Let's go see Maven. After seeing Delvin. Where's Delvin? Which is the door? Which is the door? Exit's there, it's this way. Ha! Now I remember. Delvin, oh Delvin, my dear boy. Where are you? My weird, trippy fellow.
Did you, eh? Don't look like much to me.
Delvin.
So, how about you run a job?
Delvin. Delvin, ah.
Got lots of jobs available. Interested?
What about this wonderful Queen Bee statue?
Well, well, I was looking for this little beauty. If you happen across any other unusual trinkets like this, be sure to bring them to me. I promise it'll be worth the effort. There you go. This should cover it.
Another 800, now that's pretty damn good. Now, did I speak to Vex about gems?
So, here we go. Loose? How about you run a job for me? Been a while since I've seen one of those. What you've got there is a stone of Baron Zaya.
Ew.
Not like that, it isn't. The stone was pried off of Baron Zaya's ceremonial crown by a thief in order to cover his tracks.
And, how many of these stones are there?
I think there were 24 in all. Most people keep them as a curiosity. Some of the guild members have tried to locate them over the years, but they haven't been successful. Well, until now.
Oh. Sure you're not gonna buy it?
Look, I only buy things I can turn around quickly for a profit. And no one wants these stones unless they have the whole set. Tell you what, if you find the rest of them, talk to me again. Otherwise, keep it. Maybe it'll bring you luck.
Yeah, we'll see. Well, I've got 4 of them so far, so I've only got 20 left. I think, in one episode, I'll go on a hunt for them. Until then, I'll stay in our wonderful little pocket. I'm doing my best right now not to go mental about the vacuum, but it might actually be my neighbour from downstairs clearing up, because she's leaving now. Shame, really. Ooh. Letter for Rune? Yes. I think that comes up later. So we'll go see Maven, and then I think we will move on with bits of the main quest, if not just to bump into the Greybeards. I need to anyway. Is he sun up now? He's sun up. There we go. Maven, where are you? Aha!
So you're the one. You don't look so
impressive. Beg your pardon, madam. There we go.
This is exactly what I'm talking about. Once again, really? Brynjolf sends me someone with no backbone, no determination. Faith. I don't have faith in anyone. All I care about is cause and effect. Did the job get done, and was it done correctly? There's no grey area.
Love, you've watched too much of the Matrix sequels.
I hope not. This is an important job. I have a competitor called Hunting Brumidery that I want to put out of business. I also want to know how they managed to get the place up and running so quickly.
So, alright, where do I begin?
Head to the Bannered Mare in Whiterun and look for Malus Machius. He'll fill you in on all the details.
Will he now? Well,
one more time.
Before we see Malus, like I said, we're gonna crack on with something else. Do love those eyes I chose for her. Right, so we get that one. So much to do. Where is it? There we go. One of the voice. And I've also got clinic supplies still on me, I do believe. So, dive instead! Yes, magical drums, which you never use. Never. There's no freaking need to just destroy everything. It's because you're being an awesome sneak thief. I'm pretty sure that if you use rune spells. Excuse me. Enemies will still pinpoint and track you as though you fired a spell at them recently. Rather bizarre. I'll zoom out, thank you. Our way up to 10,000 steps. Oh, it's been so freaking long since I've done this. Now, I get the feeling I'm gonna have frost trolls and it's a bear! Oh, I put away my weapon. No, that's not bad. There we go. That bit wrong. Where's my shield? Shield. Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Bear. Cicero, you're over there. Shh. He murdered a goat. I'm sorry, Mr. Goat. I wasn't there to save you. Oh, well. Where's Shadowmere gone anyway? Oh well, he'll turn up. Sure he will. Unless someone's murdered him. I certainly hope not. Goatee. Hello, Mr. Goat. Accursed goat. Oh, for a second there, I thought that was a person. Goat. Oh, I would have killed him with a butt shot, but he escaped. Oh, back back of the leg. Leave my goat alone.
Keep an eye out for wolves if you're headed up the path.
Nah, wolves are the least of my concern, dear boy. Farewell. Ice rites could be a thing as well up here. Sure they are. Ah, oh, there you are. Hello, Mr. Troll. Oh, you dead. That's a shame. You suck. I'm pretty sure these aren't actually 10,000 in number. Though if you were to recreate it as though it was a completely set journey up there, it would actually be, but yeah. Don't tell me you just killed the lass who's normally here. Was she on the other side? I think she's on the other side. Hope so. Yeah, no, I'll be good. Troll, where are you going? This shaft is so broken, I love it. Trolls with the classic internet troll face. Why you would want to do that, I don't know, but it is somewhat amusing. Yeah, Mr. Troll. There you go, Mr. Troll. Whoosh! Ooh! How much health did I take? Oh. Stay down. Good boy. Oh, look at that. Backflip. Thank you. Now we can just run the rest of the way because there's nothing else that's going to turn up and bash us. I hope. I really freaking hope. Skibby bee babby doo baboo. You know what? There's one specific quest I want to do on Solstheim, which I've never fully completed. I don't know why. But I definitely want to read all the black books. I need to read all the black books. Such awesome skills. Could go there like now, but I want to go see the Graybeards just to activate a certain event, just to help us out. Also, that monastery is so awesome. Actually, where I used to live, I was a short walk from what used to be a monastery. It's now say a priest college, a vicar college, something like that. It's still a fantastic building. Marvellous to see. And the grounds are quite large. Right, clinic supplies, where are you? Oop. So we'll go see Klimek after this. See what the Graybeards say. Hello, creepy old dudes. Let me take off my helmet. And put away my bow. Oh, I'm definitely turning off that shout as well. Take off the shield, take off that. No doubt I'll need unrelenting force. Oh, I do have it. It's fine. No iron gear.
So, a dragonborn appears at this moment in the turning of the age.
Well, did summon me, so here I am.
We will see if you truly have the gift. Show us, Dragonborn. Let us taste of your voice.
It depends how we... I hate the fact that it only has to be a relenting force. No.
Dragonborn, it is you. Welcome to High Hrothgar.
Why, thank you.
I am Master Arngeir. I speak for the Greybeards. Now, tell me, Dragonborn, why have you come here?
Well, dude, you shouted my name. So, I'm not going to call him Master. Screw that, no. I will find out what it means to be Dragon Douche.
We are here to guide you in that pursuit. Just as the Greybeards have sought to guide those of the dragon blood that came before you.
So, I'm not the only magical mystical being?
You are not the first. There have been many of the dragon blood since Akatosh first bestowed that gift upon mortal kind. Whether you are the only dragonborn of this age, that is not ours to know. You are the only one that has been revealed thus far. That is all I can say.
Ah, well then. Teach me!
You have shown that you are dragonborn. You have the inborn gift. But do you have the discipline and temperament to follow the path laid out for you? That remains to be seen.
Ooh.
Without training, you have already taken the first steps towards projecting your voice into a thum, a shout.
Yeah.
Now let us see if you are willing and able to learn. When you shout, you speak in the language of dragons. Thus, your dragon blood gives you an inborn ability to learn words of power.
As I have already discovered.
All shouts are made up of three words of power. As you master each word, your shout will become progressively stronger. Master Einarth will now teach you Ro, the second word in unrelenting force.
Which ones I know?
Ro means balance in the dragon tongue.
Master Bori will teach you whirling spirit.
To focus your thumb more sharply.
Ro! Look at the word. I'm looking at the word. Thank you.
Learning a word of power is a constant practice in order to use it.
Oh yes, constant practice.
Well, that is all. Learn shouts. As Dragonborn, you can absorb a slain dragon's life force and knowledge directly. As part of your initiation, Master Einarth will allow you to tap into his understanding of Ro.
Row, row, row the boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 merrily. There's a freaking dragon in the way.
Now, let us see how quickly you can master your new thumb.
Take a ship back, because I'm pretty sure this is the weird
use your
spirit thing.
Shout to for striking the target.
There's a fair few shouts displayed in this game that unfortunately you don't learn. Which is quite a shame. Oh, thanks, just shoved him in my face.
Fools, run!
One being Alduin shout, there's a shout used well done. By.
Again.
Instantly kills a dragon.
Fools, run!
Which is rather annoying and will be awesome because it instantly kills him and absorbs his soul. There's a couple of others, can't remember, I'll look them up.
Once more.
Fools, run!
Here we go.
Impressive. Your thumb is precise. You show great promise, Dragonborn. We will perform your next trial in the courtyard. Follow Master Bori.
Okie dokie.
Now, this one would be Whirlwind Sprint, and had I bothered, I could have picked up a Dragon Priest mask and one of the words of Whirlwind Sprint a while ago. And had I sorted out the Bard's College, I think it was, it would have been another word of Whirlwind Sprint I could have learned. Oh, my backside smells.
And the jester comes calling with his knife in the night.
I love you, Cicero. Please never change.
We will now see how you learn a completely new shout. Master Bori will teach you wood, which means...
Now, that would actually change the dialogue here if you had already previously learned some of the words, i.e., oh, you've been traveling a fair bit, you already know, you know, one or two words of the shout already.
Approach Master Bori and he will give it to you his danger wood.
Awesome. Also, I'm sorry, she looks badass in glass armor.
Now we will see how quickly you can master a new shout.
Where is it? No. Thank you. Now it's more of a utility, this one, but it can be extremely useful.
Then it will be your turn. Master Bori.
Go on then, Wolfgar. Show me.
Wolf! Now, it's your turn. Stand next to me. Master Bori will open the gate. Use your whirlwind sprint to pass through before it closes.
Bex.
See, now that's another one. Bex, which is beckon or open or something. That's Einarth, Wolfgar, Bori,
your
Arngir.
Quick mastery of a new thum is... astonishing. I'd heard the stories of the abilities of Dragonborn, but to see it for myself?
It kind of just happened to me, so...
You were given this gift by the gods for a reason. It is up to you to determine how best to use it. You are now ready for your last trial.
Oh, really?
Retrieve the horn of Jürgen Windcaller, our founder, from his tomb in the ancient fane of Ustengrav.
Ustengrav, oh
to the way
god.
And you will return.
It has been so long since doing any of this.
Guy,
it brings back so many memories. Right, I think, because I'm cheap and cheeky, I'm going to fast travel straight back down to Ivestead and see Klimek. And let him know that we have delivered those supplies and see how grateful he is. Shiny Axe of Doom. Shiny, come on, load. Well, thank you. Oh, there you are, Shadowmere. Took your time. Oh, hello, chaps. Or
you
chap there. And chapette.
You're the one they call Dragonborn.
Apparently. Yeah.
Then it is too late. The lie has already taken root in the hearts of men.
Pardon?
So we shall expose to them the falseness in their hearts by tearing out yours, deceiver. When Lord Mirak appears, all shall bear witness. None shall stand to oppose him.
Time to die.
Okay. I'm not particularly happy about that. Right. Seriously? This dude is just too chill. Far too chill. Oh, don't tell me you just murdered a chicken. Dude. Worst thing you can do. Moon sugar. No wonder. Ooh, shiny robes. I do like that stuff. It's a shame, it's so freaking useless. Thank you, Shadowmere, for joining in the fray.
What are you doing that for?
What am I doing what for? I just helped you out. Jeez. Glimmick, my dear boy.
Ah, good to see you again. How'd that delivery go?
Oh, quite well.
Quite a climb, wasn't it?
Fantastic.
Anyway, much appreciated. Here, take this for your troubles.
Oh, please. Seriously, dude? I was just paid 800 for robbing someone, and you just paid me $1,500 for just delivering a bag. Dude, you're awesome. Let's see what this douchebag has on him. Oh. Well. False Dragonborn, eh? And I'll take that. Ooh, pretty. And yoink. I think we have a visit to make.
Ever and always.
Which is kind of interesting because you're saying that on the American / Canadian / Australian, many other places, Mother's Day. Cicero, you are. You're such a sweet dear, aren't you? Let's go over to Windhelm Stables. I think he's trying to be Scottish. Doesn't work. You're not wearing your kilt. And there ain't no haggis. Ye, a new Scotsman. You're a Nord. Stop faking or die. And that's probably an extremely offensive accent that I just did. And some of them get pissed off at me. And you know what? I don't care. Actually, now quite a few Scotsmen in there. As brash as they are, they're actually rather nice fellows. Ouch. Whee! Swimming in icy cold water that would give hypothermia and kill you. Yeah, pleurisy, pneumonia. Or, if you're really unfortunate, the two diseases would actually develop and mingle and become pleuropneumonia, which is about 99% incurable, because by the time they catch it, you're buggered. So, yeah.
If you're looking for passage to Solstheim, too bad. I'm not going back there anymore.
Oh, really? Well, you need to give me a damn good reason why.
It's hard to explain. I remember those people with the masks coming on board. Then... the next thing I remember, I was here, and they were gone. That's not right, losing whole days like that.
It's okay, I'll just
something strange
wait.
Going on there for a while. But after this, I'm done. I'm not going back to Solstheim.
Bud, you are. You're going to take me there, or else I'm going to kill you myself.
Have you been listening to me? I'm not going back there.
Dude, seriously, I'm going to find out where these idiots came from because they tried to kill me. And hopefully we'll be able to sort something out for you.
All right, you have a point. Taking you back to find out who sent them is the least I can do. Besides, maybe you can put a stop to whatever's going on over there. I owe them a bit of payback myself.
Woohoo! And off to Solstheim. Look at that. Starring. I love that stuff. Though, I have never made anything out of Starring. Which is really annoying because I love the weapon designs, especially the greatsword. And the fact that they get additional bonuses with any ice enchantments. Including the new Chaos enchantment, which has a 50% chance of doing fire, frost, or lightning damage. And also the only forced cutscene in the entire game.
Well, here we are.
Not so forced, but
this is Raven.
Specific perspective that you give
us. I'm all that glad to see it again. Good luck. Maybe you can figure out what's going on around here.
Now, I remember when this was first released and they were bringing out trailers and what for, and I myself was getting extremely excited. I was excited for all the DLC. And it just looked so awesome, and the giant shrooms and everything else. Alright, just do your autosave and freeze on me. Thank you.
I don't recognize you, so I'll assume this is your first visit to Ravenrock, Outlander. State your intentions.
I'm here looking for a chap called Mirak.
Mirak, I'm not sure that I do. Just remember, Ravenrock is sovereign territory of House Redoran. This is Morrowind, not Skyrim. While you're here, you will be expected to abide by our laws.
No, that
any questions?
Do. How can you be so suspicious of people?
I have to be. As Second Counselor, the security of Ravenrock is my primary concern.
Well, has your security been an issue?
This isn't exactly the city of Blacklight. We're on the frontier out here. We've had more than a fair share of troubles. After all we've been through together, I refuse to let Councillor Morvain down.
Well, that's a fair point. What about your titles?
Councillor Morvain is House Redoran's representative on Solstheim. As Second Councillor, it's my job to support him and make certain his rule is enforced.
All right. And,
remember,
I'll get going.
We are watching you. Giolan,
you can keep watching me all you want, buddy. And this armor. Awesome.
Mandori over at the Iron Farm should be still mixing potions if you're seeking that sort of thing. Far west end of town.
Look at it. It's a shame we don't actually see the beast that it's made from. Because that was back in the game called Morrowind. Which I never played.
Just remember who's in
charge. Now, hopefully. Yes, Glover will be at his forge. Hello, Glover. Which, every time I keep saying that, I keep thinking of the game by the same name. Which was really weird.
You haven't seen Crecius Corellius, have you? That foolish old man's taken my pickaxe again.
No, I haven't. But, what's up with this bloody pickaxe then?
No, this isn't just your run-of-the-mill pickaxe. I'm talking about an ancient Nordic pickaxe.
They don't exactly
grow on trees, you know.
Well, just tell the guards.
I prefer to handle these things on my own.
But
look, if you see Precious, tell him to give me that pickaxe back, and I'll pay you for the trouble.
So you want to deal with this yourself? You're asking me to do it? Okay, fine, weirdo. Oh, and by the way, I noticed that shadow mark just to the left of your door.
Well, well, it's been a long time since someone from the guilds bothered to make their way out here. So tell me, how's my brother Delvin? Still spending his nights at the Ragged Flagon trying to win Vex's heart?
Yeah, he's still trying. He's doing pretty well.
Good to hear. Tam Layabout never even bothers to send his own flesh and blood a letter saying how he's doing. Can you imagine? Anyway, I suppose you're looking for work. Well, I got bad news. This place is drier than a damn bone.
Well, that's a shame. Absolutely nothing.
Eager to make some coin, eh? That's the spirit. I'll tell you what. The guild's got a problem out here that I've been trying to deal with for years, but haven't been able to handle.
Oh? Well, what's the problem then?
Don't look at me like that. I'm all alone out here, with no one to watch my back.
Well, you've got
me. Besides, it's really my problem anyway. I caused it.
Oh? How so?
A fellow Breton who went by the name Esmond Tyne showed up on my doorstep about a fortnight ago. He noticed the shadow marks like you did, and I thought he was one of us.
Ah, so, he tried to rob you blind, has he?
That he did. Right out from under my nose. Can you believe it?
Ooh, that's a right
It's my own
bribe.
Formula for improved bone mold. Took me years to perfect. Well, before he ran off, he was talking some nonsense about trying to fence goods to the Reeklings at Castle Karstag.
Oh, that's intelligent.
I told him he was crazy to even think about talking to those vicious little buggers. But he wouldn't listen. I'd bet a fat purse of coin that he's either dead or hiding out up there.
Well, I'll get that formula back for
you. You do that, and I'll make sure you're set up right. You won't be disappointed.
Right. Wow.
Well, you tell Crushes he better give that pickaxe back to me, or else.
My husband
Wendell. I'll deal with Crushes another time. I'm glad to see you. So I'm pretty sure it's going to be on the miscellaneous. There we go. Pronounced no. So let's go for a short exploration journey. I do love the outfits that they have. Not him, grumpy face.
Break that loot across my knee, and if the Barger choose to fight, why then I'll set his clothes alight.
Well, they're so simple, but they're still so nice. And the priests, oh, the priests. Anyway. This may be the Shh, Mr. Redarungard. And he, the main voice actor for the Redarungard, and for, I think he's one of the main priests here. I can't remember his name, but if anyone who is a long time follower by the Star Trek or Heroes, which was a rather awesome series many years ago, there was a particular actor. And he was just brilliant. And he's so... He plays the bad guy so damn well. And he has such a distinct voice. I just can't remember his name. The laughing... Oh, someone's in trouble. Oh, what are these? Oh, dear. Oh. No. That was... I wasn't supposed to do that one. That one. Thank you. Forgot about that.
This farm alive.
Some I of the love the accents that they give these characters here. I can't quite put it, but it's just a weird...
I don't care what they're called. All I know is there are danger to Raven Rock and they need to be stopped.
Southwestern English accent? Could it be? Might be a bit more northern, actually. I don't know my own colloquial accents from my own home country, unfortunately.
I was going to search for clues that might lead me to wherever they're coming from. I know it isn't the best place to start, but we know they've been coming from this direction.
Ooh, I'd quite gladly give you a hand. These abominations certainly need to be sorted out.
Good. I can use all the help I can get.
Clearly.
Besides, I don't feel comfortable leaving Ravenrock behind. And I'd hate to lose any more Redoran Guard.
Well, alright. Where do we start?
We were searching the farm when the Ashspawn ambushed us. Have a look around and see if you can turn up anything useful.
Alright.
Report back to me if you discover.
It's a shame that this farm is no more. Ooh, now these guys are great. If you find the really good ones, you'll start finding a lot of rather rare ores. And a declaration of war from General Falcarius, who, funnily enough, was actually in Morrowind, the game. And you do actually do a quest for him. Also, look at that. So awesome and pointy and deadly and yee. Thank you. Your sacrifice was not in vain. I now have a free set of armor.
Have you found something?
Yes. His note.
This is strange. The note says it's from General Falcarius. But that's impossible.
Is it? How? What? Why?
Well, Carius was the Imperial Garrison Commander at Fort Frostmouth. But he died over 200 years ago when the Red Mountain leveled the place. There's no way he could still be alive.
Oh, and what would you like me to do?
If General Carius is still alive, there must be something keeping him that way. I need you to head out to Fort Frostmouth and check it out. I'm going to head back to Raven Rock and prepare the men for further assaults.
Good idea, my dear boy. I'll go sort it out. Before I go, do you know of a man called Mirak?
I might know someone, though maybe not. I can't remember.
That's definitely a British thing.
I just can't be sure. I think maybe he had something to do with a temple. A temple here on the island. Does that help?
Not really.
Be careful.
I've got to go back. Because there was an interaction that I wanted to have and I didn't. Where is it? No. Thank you. Didn't realize I'd gone this far out of the town. Oh, I thought it crashed then. I would be thoroughly annoyed. Also, I've noticed I haven't been having that many dragons attack, which is rather a shame. Giant, weird, statue glowy thing. Ooh. And there he is, my favourite character.
That they have forgotten.
Hello, Neloth.
You there. You don't seem to be in quite the same state as the others here. Very interesting. May I ask what it is you're doing here?
Hello, Commander Barclay.
Mirak. It sounds familiar, and yet I can't quite place... Oh, wait, I recall. But that makes very little sense. Well, Mirak's been dead for thousands of years.
What? It certainly doesn't make any sense.
I'm not sure. But it is fascinating, isn't it?
It is.
Perhaps it has some relation to what's going on here. Quite unexpected.
Beric.
I'm afraid I can't give you any answers, but there are ruins of an ancient temple of Nerax toward the center of the island. If I were you, I'd look there.
I think I will. Have you tried to stop what's going on here?
Certainly not. Doing so would interfere with whatever is going on, and I would be unable to see how this all turns out.
Curious mind of a madman. Now, we pose this.
Now through them, does he speak. And when the world shall listen,
and when the world shall see,
will cease.
And Nella will take interest.
Here in
fascinating. By touching the stone, you appear to have fallen under whatever influence is affecting the other. Ah, so you are able to resist the effect by exerting your will.
That we might remember.
I wonder if a dragon could be captured alive. It would make a fascinating test subject.
Which is a nice reference to the main quest, which would have been more funny had I actually completed the main quest before doing this, but meh. Meh, indeed. I want to know what Shadowmere is in here. Then again, I think I need fast travel and you should turn up. Gimme. Yoink. I do so love the music in Morrowind. Well, Solstheim. It's so far removed from the feeling and the atmosphere of Skyrim itself. It's not as haunting as some of the farer reaches of Skyrim. And then some of it has a rather upbeat and rather, shall we say, a jovial sort of temperance to it. Uplifting. And yet there are other tracks in this which are just daunting. Keeping an eye open for any enemies about. Because, believe me, they'll just turn up out of nowhere. Now here is this quest that I wanted to sort. I never have. Hope you're better. Single chap, just mining away, all by himself. And yeah, the last part of this just shows that he's going mad. But, we'll find out later on.
Damn it! What am I going to do?
What's up, Rallis?
Sarah.
Oh, Sarah to you and all.
With me? What's the matter with you?
Clearly nothing, I'm not wounding myself. Sorry, I just have a
pork-faced cowards coming by to mock my efforts. It probably can't hurt to tell you. You look mostly honest. The name's Rallis. Rallis Sedaris, out of Morhold. I've got a financier waiting for me back on the mainland. Sent me here in the interests of obtaining some rare antiquities. The relics of Azador. But this whole thing became a disaster right quick, let me tell you.
How so, my dear boy?
You come out of the Northern Ashlands. You don't expect things to go easy, you know. But this was something outside my particular expertise.
Oh?
When I first got to Kolbjorn, you couldn't even see it. Buried in the ash, like most other things on this blasted island. Dug out a pile of the stuff taller than me just to find the barrel.
Who knows how much to reach the door? Excavating isn't exactly my specialty. Even if it was, the ash storms fill it in faster than you can dig.
You know, you've got a town full of miners. Why not just hire a few?
You think I've got that kind of money? No, I only get paid on delivery. Can't afford to go out of pocket for 1,000 septums on this.
Yeah.
Takes money to make money, all that rot. There's a lot of it at the other end. But I can't get there without a little kick to start it off.
That's a rather subtle hint, my dear boy, but... You know what? I'll offer you this.
Want to
be a
partner? What? Are you serious? Well, I think I could make that work. We can sort out the details of our little arrangement later. But for now, I'll manage the dig if you can manage the coin. Do you have the gold?
Well, it depends on how much you're asking. 1,000?
It's all here. Well then, looks like I have a good bit of work to start on.
Also, I love the fact that you're holding pickaxe in your hands once while I'm getting equipped, and somehow still managed to count out my gold.
Pleasure doing business with you, partner. I'll see you soon.
I'll see you soon, Rallis. Indeed. Such an interesting fellow. Right, I only want the one. Best line. So that one can go off. And so we want to go north. Ooh. Now these are an interesting item. And they come into play a little bit later on. Also, it takes longer to mine these than it does a standard ore vein. Because with a standard ore vein, it takes 3 hits, whereas with a Heartstone ore, it takes 4 per chunk that you would get. Look at this. Nothing but dead trees, a few pines still trying to grow. It's a shame, really. But the Heartstones come from... what's it called? That mountain over there. Can't remember the name of it. These are what I think they are. Yeah. Albino spider pods. These little critters. These are awesome though. Love how they're sporadic and here, there, and everywhere. You just come across them and you think, that's just creepy. But those will be interesting for a few quests later on. Ooh, important landmark. Ooh, creep clusters. Not as good as the mainland creep clusters, but they're still pretty good. Yes. stuff. Shame it's heavy armor. And there's Stormfang. Interestingly named weapon, but I do certainly like it. How you doing there, Cicero? You struggling, dude? I want to do our healing hands. Don't remember. No, it wasn't shouts, it was restoration. Healing hands. Cicero? Oh, finally. Oh no, it's the shouters.
Cicero is at humble Cicero.
Yeah, the shouters weakened him. Oh, okay. Shout Mr. Warnock, but he's still got purple swirls. No, it's still going down. I must have gotten to the negative numbers then. And, ooh, Elven War Axe. Take your gold. Thank you. What have you got? Woven sword, lockpick, standard bone mould. How dull. What's that bear trap there? Strange. Regular chest has got that. Oh! Ooh! Pretty.
Need to get mother some flowers.
Might as well get the art stone. Because even if they don't use them, they still fetch a high price. Did you do any more weapons about? Any more shiny things? Could do the other half stone, but no, I want to keep going. Ooh, the chest. What's in this one? It's locked. No! Gimme. And for anyone who lives in England, you may actually remember that show. It was coming back. A bit older. That was weird. Fun show to watch. I think for the age I was, the humour was supposed to be above me, but if you've ever met my mother, no, I got the humour. And as you guys just saw, I've just leveled up to 82. So, thank you, wonderful, the legendary patch that came at the very end. I think, when was it? I think it was actually a full year after everything. Yes, it was quite some time after the Dragonborn DLC. Also, remember this place for later. Locked as it may be, we'll have to find it. If it is abandoned,
why there now why is there fire going?
Ooh. Anyway, yes, thanks to the legendary patch, the level cap was removed from 81 and a half, so you can just level up indefinitely, hence why you've seen me put legendary onto a couple of my skills, allowing me to keep going. So we level up. So I've got 500 and everything. We will put something to magic as well. Let's start on that. Not that I really need to, but it depends on whether or not I want to have a complete reduction on certain spells or not. And also it will help out with other things. Also, a fair few dwarven ruins around. The dwarves did get about a bit, I must say. What's up here? No, why have I still got the spells? Silly. Go on, Cicero, my dear boy. Also, That one in the middle of the bar is Mirak's temple. Reeklings. Hello. You little buggers. Where's my ship? Thank you. Seriously, Cicero, you're struggling with the Reeklings. Dude, you're supposed to be one of the best. Assassin's better. Who seriously steals a deer bust? Obviously these crazy motherfuckers. Ah, yes. This is Strongbox I'm thinking of. East Empire Trading Co. There's a chap in Ravenrock. He's quite happy to pay for these. Now, we value them at 25 gold. He will pay you 500 per necklace. Don't think you can actually wear them either. Which is a bummer. Anything? Okay, bear belt. Both in the house. Waters. Where was I going? That way. Let's hope I don't die on the way down. It'd be extremely embarrassing. Ooh. Okay. Fire. Oh! Reeklings! Little shit. I love how they die. It might have been a bit high pitched. Bellows, seriously. Weirdos. Skull hat. They put on a weird thing. Fur helmet, which are extremely rare. Bone mold helmet. I don't know why they had helmets around that. Come on. I want to have a look at all these goodies. Nah. Also, Reaver, you are terrible. You died from your own stupidity.
Perhaps anyway. We should find a stranger to murder. Practice does.
Died. What's that? Why is everyone thinking? Oh, hello, Mr. Troll.
Loon? Ow!
Chuppy chuppy. Anything of worth?
No.
just get to where we need to go. Now there is a bird wall up there, but we'll come back to there. Unless of course there's a dragon flying around now, which then obviously we'll need to take care of him. Ooh, sacrifice. Oh dear. Oh dear, oh dear. I think we will have to. Yeah, ooh, sugar. And here's one of the new dragon types that was introduced in Dragonborn. Serpentine dragon. Which you don't see many of, unfortunately. Come on, dude. Where are you? And there's a load of Draugr. I don't like the Draugr. There he is. Seriously? Frost Troll just comes out of nowhere. Strength. Yeah, I'll do. thing. What do we got? Potion, potion, soul gem, soul gem. Elixir resist fire. What was my voice doing then? I do not know. Siren's watch. Think down and around. No. Though there are. Sword of Burning. I think there was supposed to be another weapon. Sure, there's supposed to be two weapons here. There it is. Earth bend will. Yes. I think one word allows me to start cleansing the stones, and then two words will allow me to bend the will of men. And then three words will allow me to bend the will of dragons. Oh no, I didn't mean to pick those up. Put them back. Put them back. Eye braces, iron boots, steel shoe boots. Still, no, we can stay there. Still over encumbered. Oopsie. That's what I get for not sorting things out. Cluster, bear claw, E, pistol board. To here and pick up the item before speaking to Glover. Oh, I thought Sister was there. Come on, do the loading. Yeah, if you were to come here before speaking to Glover, you would actually mock up this little side quest, and the reward and the bonus to the bone mold armor would be lost forever, which would be a huge shame, really. We go sneaky sneaky, because I don't particularly want to go dealing with the Reeklings. It's too many. Once you aggro one, they all come after you. But, there we go. Now, you can't take his armour, but that armour that he's wearing is, what is it now? There's a group of thieves that he went up hunting down for a side quest for the Thieves Guild, and they wear the exact same armour. But look at that. Nice, isn't it? Damnation. Ooh. That's what we were here for. And seriously? But, nah. That was the gift of his brother. And I'm back. Oh, is this around? Nice of you to turn up. Come here, I'm giving you some armor. Look, seriously, I'm swimming slow, being open and covered.
Cicero is at your
service. And there you are as well. Cicero is his servant, my dear boy. Especially seeing him playing in the water as well.
His work.
Take spears at least.
Has just begun.
Give you some bone mold. Helmet. Maybe the pauldron armor and a shield.
Humble.
Not exactly sneaky, is it? Go on then, lads. Let's get the heck out of here and go see. Oop, Glover. Oops. To say, right, let's go straight off to Glover and get our reward. Why would you link poisons and potions together? I don't know. Some pilchard will end up picking up the wrong bottle and kill themselves. I also like how they keep the poisons and whatnot to more square shaped fat bottles, whereas potions and poultices are more so in smoother shaped bottles. Just point out, Glover!
Any luck tracking down Esmond?
Yep. Yeah, he's dead. But I got your formula.
I told him not to head up there. Sounds like the bloody fool got what he deserved. Here, I want you to take this key. Head inside my house and unlock the door in the basement. Help yourself to whatever you like inside. I won't be using it anymore.
Fair enough. And, Cicero and the Redoran Guard are getting a bit, intimate by the looks of it.
You tell Crecius he better give that pickaxe back
weird.
To me.
Or else. So, with... At least with the bone mold having that, we go down to.
There we go. My blade.
Have a look. Should be improved, which is, you know, the standard pauldron version. But if you look, it's only an extra 2 points, and it is heavier by what? Oops, quite a bit. But overall, that all adds up.
Of darkness.
Which is pretty awesome. Anyway, let's go into Glover's house and actually find our lovely reward.
You've been a good friend
to me.
No, dude,
move.
That means something.
Thank you. It's going into your house. Right.
Glover Mallory's the name. If you're looking for a smith, you...
Dude, now you're just repeating yourself. I don't think there's anything fancy here, except for feathers. Weird. Now, can I? Should be able to without getting a bollocking. That's another pendant we can have. No, come on. Be nice to me, game. Now I'm about to, save everything and turn it all off. Take that. Don't need to steal from him because...
There is murder in the air.
Look at those lanterns. So nice. What's in the air? No, cabbage. Keep your cabbages. Ba-ba-ba. Anything else? No. Ha-ha!
The
no, I didn't want to pick up the basket. Garlic is good, wheat is good. Take those. And yes, I am purposely avoiding things. Staging arrows, rule of semithirst, prime elixir of escape. Nice, and I'm pretty sure that actually restores every now and then. It's potion of light feet, pickpocketing, ultimate healing, wonderful shadow mark banners. Ooh. Daedric's Sword of Petrifying. Paralysis is awesome. Why a high shield of resist shock, I don't know. Glover's letter, which is addressed to Sapphire. Which We will deliver to her. I'll read it before we do, at least. Strong box with a flawless emerald. Soul gems, some poisons. Shining Sujama, Blackbriar Mead, ha ha ha. Sweet rolls, more Blackbriar that is the reserve, really fancy stuff. Yeah, come on, gold, lockpicks, anything else? Well, now for our final prize, the Blackguard armor.
All hail the savior of the Dark Brotherhood. All hail the list.
Absolutely, that's why. Boop, 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 and boop.
No.
Let's kill someone!
That one hood you always want but you can never get. Sleeveless top, nice wrist guards. If I remember rightly, 25% boost on prices, which is fantastic. 40% increase in lock picking, 40% pickpocketing, and 50 points to carry, which far outweighs the guildmaster gear that you end up getting from completing the Thieves Guild. Which is a shame, really, but at the same time,
he awaits us.
You should have got this after completing all the main quests anyway. But, this will be the set I'm going to be rocking now for the rest of the Thieves Guild. And on that note, I think it's time I call it a day because, oh god, an hour and three quarters. At least I'm making up for the last episode, guys. So sorry again for the wait. But thanks again for coming along. Hopefully you'll join me for more antics around Solstheim and Skyrim. And for now, take care.